Hey everybody, Matt here from Aroundsquare. I'm just coming to you with another drop announcement, a little bit of a rundown of the things that we're launching next Friday at the end of this month, January 2022. I want to start by saying that we're coming into this year with probably more momentum than Aroundsquare has ever had as a company. We had a ton of projects that started last year that got a little bit delayed, but that means that now when that stuff all comes to fruition, we've got a ton of stuff kind of in the queue. We've also staffed up. We're up to six people now working on Aroundsquare. We've got four of us here, including my wife and I, and two overseas working for us. So we've got busy, busy times and lots going on, and I think it's going to be a great year. I want to start by addressing the mystery posted on social media. I'm not going to give you the answer, but I want to share with you this beautiful piece here. This is a mini knucklebone, and I've got a glove on for a reason. You'll find out about that reason if you read our launch email. It's handled with care, but it's a beautiful, beautiful piece. I'm excited about it. I've got another one of these that's not quite so, as we say, precious, but it's still pretty beautiful. And details are in our launch newsletter. Now, probably the headliner for the launch this month is going to be the titanium version of the Remeshok Chetki. These were due, I think, in October, and they just kept getting delayed. Turns out they were quite a challenge for our supplier to manufacture, but we've since gotten it through the manufacturing. They had to repair their equipment a number of times. In the process, we actually lined up a couple of other suppliers as well for these. So I think going forward, we're going to be fine. And in the short term, we have a good selection of these in stock in inventory. So I don't expect them to sell out, not immediately. I do expect them to be popular, but if you're not right there, you know, right in the first 5 minutes of the drop, you should still be safe. They're pricey because it's 20 beads altogether, and it's kind of a more delicate manufacturing process than our bigger beads usually are. So, you know, go into it kind of expecting that. It's they're beautiful. They're strung on 300-pound Kevlar cord. They're meant to last a lifetime. And when we launched the brass and delrin versions, I didn't kind of go into this feature very much. Actually, it's more of a bug than a feature, but it's, you know, I've found myself actually wearing these a lot, and you can see here, the process of putting them on and taking them off isn't that difficult. You basically just slide that bead at the end through the slack, and if you're having trouble with it, it probably means that your slack is not quite enough, but then you take it off. Basically, you kind of pop the slack down like that, and then you slip the ends through. The hardest part is that I've got two ends here. If I tie them together, it'd be easier. But then you just slide it through, and then I use that little bit of extra slack to slip it over my wrist. And then once it's past my hand, you pull it past the bead, and it stays in place. I go running with these on my wrist. They don't come off. It's you know, basically like a jewelry clasp of some sort or another. So, you know, when you're considering the hefty price tag on these, think about it as a wearable as well. You know, they're if you go for that kind of thing, great. If not, they disappear into the pocket, and you know, I've ended up with this being kind of oftentimes the only thing I carry with me, just because they're so versatile. You can sling them. They're great for raindrops or bead counting, and it's just kind of a nice kind of slick little item to have around. So I don't know. I'm not trying to be the salesman on these, but of all of the Remeshoks that we've got, this is definitely my favorite. I got to say that when I design products, I generally design for titanium, you know, with the weight in mind. So it's no accident that the brass ones are a little bit hefty and the delrin ones are a little bit light, because I try to design the size and the shape of the beads so that the weight of titanium will come in at kind of what I consider to be roughly optimal. So there's that. And then we've also got the full range of delrin colors coming in now. All right. Now, as you can imagine, we would quickly drive ourselves crazy if we tried to do all of the different combinations of accents and customs and so on. What I've decided to do, since we're adding materials, we also are working on copper and aluminum and stainless steel in this design. What I've decided to do is just stick with purebred materials, you know, single color, single material for the majority of them. And if you want accent packs, I'm going to do accent packs with the ends and one stripe bead available in all of the materials, all of the colors. And I'm also going to do extension packs of both two beads and four beads. So that should give you all a pretty good range of options if you want to kind of customize, mix and match and so on. For the delrin, I'll probably also do a custom option for a few bucks more. You can just specify your colors and away you go, all right? So that's the Remeshoks. And I wanna quickly get into some of the other stuff. We've got also long form delrin ultras. So these are the commons beads. We launched the short form of the delrin a couple months ago, and I don't know, there's just something so nice about delrin, as you all know. It is a plastic, and I generally am not that into plastics, but I make an exception for delrin just because it's so tough and durable, and it's got that warm feeling to the touch. For these beads, it has an awesome clack, right? And although we started off the Ultras line with the short forms kind of single wrap bracelet, I actually quickly gravitated to the long form myself. I like the setup. I like the double wrap, the way it looks and so on. And you can get away with, as I've mentioned before, a bit of a shorter tassel on the end, not quite as much slack, because you get a little bit of extra slack from the double wrap on the wrist loop there, right? So these are going to be similar kind of price structure to the short form delrin ultras. Basically, like roughly multiply the number of beads and you'll get kind of the factor for how I come up with the pricing on these. All right, that's the delrin ultras. Moving along, because I know I always go a long time on these. New contact balls. Okay, contact balls have been really popular. If you tried to get in on the contact balls earlier and were put off by the shipping price, I actually have found and added a new option to the pricing. It's expedited parcel for Americans. For Europeans and other countries, I'm sorry, I don't have other options for you at this point. We are exploring like DHL, UPS and so on. They all seem to be more expensive at this point. But for Americans, if you go expedited parcel, it is a tracked shipment. It's not a fast tracked shipment, but it's it at least gives you tracking, and it goes by surface, and it's not super slow. That's what I use for wholesale orders to like Yo-Yo Sam and so on, the big heavy parcels, and they usually arrive, you know, within a week or two. It's like, you know, it's roughly similar to the airmail, to be honest. What we're launching this month for the contact balls is 30 millimeter size. So these guys are, you can see they're tiny. They're gonna actually ship in a knucklebone box and they fit in there comfortably. So these, they play fine and they're actually like pocket size. Although I gotta say, like with the copper and the brass, stainless steel, you're gonna feel them in your pocket for sure. The titanium, it's interesting, I don't have them here in front of me, but the titanium are small and light enough that they actually take a little bit more effort to get them rolling with momentum. But they do work. I often carry around the titanium set myself, just because if I'm out and about and I don't really want something swinging around in my pocket, the titanium is a good choice. And then you can either just like, you know, play them discreetly in your hand, or if you want to do the momentum play with the beads or the balls rather separated, you can do that as well. All right. So we're offering the copper and brass in 30 millimeter size, as well as 35, which is these guys here, and 40. We don't have copper and brass in the 50 or the 70 size at this point, but you know, we'll see. Future is long. The 30 millimeter size, we're going to do copper, brass, titanium, and stainless steel. All right. Next up is our notebooks. I've been excited about this. I've been kind of teasing them online. They've been showing up in my photos. These are them here. So it's kind of an unconventional size. For those of you who are stationary nerds, you might recognize this as the Midori Traveler's Notebook size. And it is based on that size dimension. I was a Traveler's Notebook guy for quite a while and enjoyed that. But I didn't like how flimsy the covers were and how, you know, they tend to be like just the, what do you call it, like perfect bound, stapled back. And I didn't like that much. It didn't feel substantial enough for me and not very many pages. These are hardbound. Got a nice solid cover, but it does have a bit of flex to it. And the pages are 80 gram. It's got a thin grid, 5 millimeter grid. It's very light, so it doesn't obscure what you're writing, but it's nice. And it's a lay flat cover. The cover's actually got a neat design. I don't know what to call this, but you see it on children's books often. It's crack proof, so the spine isn't directly attached to the pages at the back there. And it's, they're really robust, durable. I use them all the time. This is my go-to right here. I've got some stuff jammed in it, which I'll talk about later, but yeah. All right, what else? Ranger eyes. And yeah, of course, I don't have them here. So these are these funky little patches. As some of you know, Aroundsquare has been in the patch game for a long time. Starting way back when we did our first Everyman Baglari launch, we did patches, and I've always liked the Velcro kind of morale patch type things. These Ranger Eyes have become popular recently, and they're just like a small form factor in Velcro back. It doesn't come with the other side of the Velcro, but a lot of EDC patches or packs and day packs and so on have a little Velcro swatch on it. And you just slap these on, and the idea is like people kind of, they're a bit collectible, I guess. People will mix and match them, repping their favorite brands. I'm really keen on these, actually. I really like them. And we did, I think, I can't remember if we did 100 or 200 of each. But I'm going to make these kind of, you know, one and done for each design. I'm planning to do more in the future. We'll mix it up with some different designs. But if you're into this sort of thing, then grab them while you can, because, you know, they're not going to be exorbitantly priced. And I'm looking forward to selling through my inventory so I can do some other designs. All right, next up is shirts. Huh. Probably like the first video I've ever done without a white shirt on. And I figured I may as well model this guy for you guys. So it's got the one of the Aroundsquare logos on the back and a little word mark on the front. And there was it, the Gildan soft style. So it's like a cotton poly blend, but it's really, really soft, comfortable. It's the first non-white shirt I've worn in ages, but I actually quite like it. It's a good kind of basic fit. Next thing, actually, we're almost through to the end of it, guys. I'm excited about this one. This is something very different for Aroundsquare. We're doing a little leaflet, and it's going to be free. And I'm psyched about it. It's I'm calling it The Difference Between an Orange, Mind Control and Metacognition Monthly, and it's just like a little collection of like paradoxes, puzzles, concepts, and so on that I think are a good accompaniment to some of the toys that we do. You know, we joke online a lot about social engineering and mind control. And honestly, it's only half joking. The social engineering thing came from back in my days when I was an elementary school teacher and joked about myself being a social engineer. And the mind control aspect is really just around like critical thinking and mindfulness and focus and mental fitness and all of that stuff. And although our products are not explicitly, you know, designed for that, I hear all the time about people who use them, you know, to deal with anxiety, helping with addictions recovery, mindfulness, just PTSD, you name it. And, you know, for people who are what, like neuronormals, great. You probably just enjoy playing with them. But for people who are a little bit diverse in that respect, the toys, the products all offer something different for each of us. Part of what makes them great is their versatility, and people come at them from all different angles. And so this little newsletter leaflet type thing is just a little accompaniment, a compliment to the products that we're selling. So it's I'm not going to be like forcing it on anybody, throwing it in with orders. But if you want a copy, they're going to be free, and just add it to your order, and I'll stuff it in the envelope. Next up, another thing I'm psyched about: the B Bank. Started off as the Baglari Bank. It was kind of our way to spread Baglari love, and we used to have this kind of convoluted procedure with a form and like a lottery, and we're basically we give away free Buglieri sets, but we kind of put people through paces for it, and at the same time it created a lot of work for us to have to like kind of sort through the the applications. And I've made it simpler now. I've got tons, as you can imagine, tons of like B-grade beads, stuff that I've used for videos and dinged up a little bit, so it's not good to sell, but I don't really play it. So what we've started doing is just tumbling all of that stuff with a good kind of a good mix of media. And we're going to be offering the knucklebones, dead eyes, and Buglieri at this point for people just for free. People are gonna have to pay the shipping. I don't want people, you know, in it to scam me or just like, you know, trying to get free stuff. It kills my motivation when I see people trying to abuse the system. But these are going to be free for basically anybody who, on an honor system, thinks they need it. You know, they can't afford our products. We don't want that to be a barrier to people benefiting from them. So they're going to be free. The only thing you need to do is pay the shipping, because I don't want it to be a project where we're having to subsidize it a bunch. At some point we may do, I don't know, some kind of a scholarship or free shipping. Or I've got lots of ideas around it, but at this point the easiest way to do it is just to put it in our shop as an item. So the B-Bank will be like an item in a product listing in our shop. The price is going to be like a lot, like $100 or something for per item. But for people who visit the B-Bank page, it's going to be, there's a promo code on there. You enter the promo code, it kills the price of the item. So all you're left with is the shipping cost. Okay, so that's how it's going to work. If you're an existing customer just looking to add stuff to your collection, obviously this isn't for you. This is meant for people who can't afford our products or people going through a rough patch. Maybe you've got a friend that you think would benefit from them, but you know they're like, man, I don't know if it's worth $20 or $50 or whatever. You know, put the word out. This is all about spreading the love of these items, and I hope that people will use it in the right way. And yeah, I'm looking forward. You know, there are some longtime community members who found us through the original B-Bank and are still like, you know, members of the community. Some of those guys have actually gone on to kind of turn their situations around, or like they found a better spot, got a new job or whatever, and have become customers. So it's not business development for me. It is honestly about spreading the love of these things and the benefits, because I think that, you know, I hear all the time that people are benefiting from them in one way or another. And I want to bring that to more people. And at the same time, you know, I've got all of this extra product lying around that I don't want to sell because it's like a little bit perfect or dinged up. And it's a great way to put that stuff to use, right? So please spread the word about the B-Bank to your friends and relatives and so on that you think might benefit from it. And if you're like part of an organization, like a, you know, youth groups or rehab groups or, you know, probation or whatever, like get in touch and we'll see if we can get some of these things sent your way as well, all right? Okay, last little announcement is we've got a new lineup, a new roster for the AO2 crew, and I'm super pumped about it. It's been a long time since we've added new members. Starting in February, we're going to be bringing out the list. I guess we're going to do like one announcement per day. I think we got like six or seven folks lined up, and they're all like, as you can imagine, top of the game in one toy or another. Super excited for all of this stuff. I'll finish up here today with a couple of quick teasers. Some of you have seen and noted these pens that look a little bit different. Yes, and they're super hot. These are the first prototype of our fountain pens. So they're just factory samples at this point. I'm going to adjust a couple of things on the design, but so far I love them. They're obviously based on the aesthetics of the Chaos pens. They're a little bit thicker, fatter, to accommodate the ink and the nib and so on, but still a good pocket pen. Okay, what else I got? I got these things. I've held off on, like, I really wanted to post a photo online, but I held off because I knew people would go crazy for them. These are acrylic Chetki beads. Okay, so I've been getting more and more into the acrylics. The stuff is just so beautiful and it has great properties for our toys. So look forward to more and more of this stuff. On those lines, I've got also here commons beads. I don't know if you can catch these in the light. These are also just beautiful. Okay. So I guess I'll leave it there, guys. That's a lot to go through and I guess a lot more to look forward to. We got so much more lined up for this year. We got some new toys. We got tons more clothing stuff planned. We got vests coming in. We got, I'm even working on a pocket knife. Okay. Oh, there, I said it. Look forward to it. Okay. I said too much already. Bye.